In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world.
For our goodnight message on this Sunday, the 20th of August 2023, broadcasting from Don Bosco Youth Center in Chingola, Zambia, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with the gospel passage of today entitled Challenging Lessons from the Canaanite Woman. Just the other day, should I say, a week ago, on the 9th of August, we had lessons from the Canaanite woman, and here we are again drawing other lessons from this same Canaanite woman, and we are drawing these lessons from a different perspective. The Canaanite woman we read about from Matthew chapter 15, verse 21 to 28, has a lot of lessons for us. First lesson that we learn is that we are all hopelessly lost. We like to think that we have it together, but the reality is we don't. We are more sinful than we ever dared think. Romans chapter 3, verse 23. We are hopelessly unstuck on this path that will eventually lead us to death unless the Savior comes to our rescue. The Canaanite woman got that. She understood her condition and saw Jesus as her only hope. This Canaanite woman is the Syrophoenician woman. She was in a hopeless situation, but then she ran into Jesus and everything changed. The message of the gospel is that you and I are sinners, damned, but yet dearly loved. We can have hope not in our own abilities, but in what Jesus has done for us. When we recognize our sinful, hopeless condition, it will make what Jesus has done for us even sweeter. The second lesson we draw from this woman is that we don't deserve God's grace. We are an entitled people. We walk around thinking life owes us, and this attitude bleeds into our faith. Many Christians act that it was God's pleasure to die for us. We deserve it after all. We actually deserve eternal separation from God. We don't deserve God's grace. We certainly didn't earn it. We are screwed up many times. We deserve death, not life. But God doesn't give us what we deserve. He gives us what we need, and that's God's grace. The Canaanite woman understood this. She recognized that she didn't deserve it, but God gave it anyway. She experienced grace firsthand. We need to let go of this mindset that we are deserving of Jesus' sacrifice for us. We aren't, but He went to the cross anyway. Why? Because of His deep love for us. When we understand that we aren't deserving, it elevates our understanding to a new level. Thirdly, our problems should draw us to God. This Syrophoenician woman was an outsider. She wasn't a Jew or a follower of Jesus, and yet in her greatest need, she was drawn to Jesus. I don't know about you, but that's not how I operate. In my problems, I tend to try to fix them myself. It rarely works out, but it doesn't stop me from trying. I doubt I am alone in this. This Canaanite woman shows us a better way. Bring your problems to Jesus. He cared for her and He will care for you too. His love for us is deep, and He wants to care for His children. When we try to solve our own problems, we often end up more stuck. Go to Jesus instead. He is a good father that wants to help His children. Your problems should draw you to God.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.